Thank you all for being here today. I'd like to begin by saying thank you to Chancellor Woodson, Dean Danowitz, and their teams at NC State for hosting us here today and allowing us to use the Bayou Manufacturing Training and Education Center to make this very special education announcement. I would like to recognize our higher education partners, UNC System President Margaret Spellings, Dr. Hope Williams, President of the North Carolina Independent Colleges and Universities, and our North Carolina State Superintendent Mark Johnson. I would also like to thank my colleague, Representative Horn, for his commitment to students, teachers, and education reform. You will hear from him just a little bit more in a minute. And to recognize also our colleagues from the North Carolina House and Senate who are here with us today, who also share that vision and have participated with us in this process. Each of the people standing behind me played an important role in the reason we are here, and that is why we are standing together. Today, we are here to announce the creation of the new North Carolina Teaching Fellows Program. Our state and the state of public education was in bad shape coming out of the Great Recession. Salaries were frozen, teachers were furloughed, and programs were cut. But that is not where we are today. Since 2011, the House and Senate have worked together to bring North Carolina's commitment back by tackling important education reforms that seek to improve student outcomes, raise teacher pay, reward our best teachers, and connect our classrooms digitally. Today, we are facing a new crisis, though: competition. Our schools are facing a great need for the best and brightest teachers in science, technology, engineering, and mathematics fields, as well as special education. We know our educational leaders need tools to attract the best and brightest to our classrooms, and our students deserve it. The 2015-2016 North Carolina State of the Teaching Profession Report shows that since 2013, the top five most difficult to staff subject areas, as reported by local school districts, are math, science, and special education across different grade levels. In 2015, 90 school districts reported having difficulty staffing high school math teachers. At the end of last session, I chaired a Senate work group that was focused specifically on addressing teacher recruitment, retention, and education preparation challenges in North Carolina. We put together a strong team, which included Senator Tamara Berger, Senator Deanna Ballard, and Senator Jerry Tillman, those who are with us today. We went on a listening tour to our schools of education at Meredith, at NC State, at Shaw University. We met with interest groups and educational leaders from across North Carolina to discuss and generate ideas on how the legislature can improve recruitment, retention, and education preparation in our state. And we have developed a package of policies through collaboration that we will be introducing over the coming weeks through the Senate's education budget and other efforts. But today, we want to outline one specific recommendation from those proposals. Our work group committed to Representative Horn and other leaders in the House that we would work collaboratively with higher education and K-12 leaders from across North Carolina to deliver a top-notch premier program that was responsive to our state's needs. Today is a fulfillment of that promise. Through much collaboration, input, and feedback, we have arrived at a proposal that we all stand strongly behind, and I would like to explain it to you. The North Carolina Teaching Fellows Program establishes a distinguished, forgivable loan program for teachers who demonstrate a desired commitment to serve in STEM or special education subject areas and agree to teach in our North Carolina public schools. The purpose of this program is to recruit, prepare, and support students residing in or attending our institutions of higher education for preparation as highly effective STEM or special education teachers in our state public schools. The bill establishes the North Carolina Teaching Fellows Commission through appointments made by the UNC Board of Governors and the General Assembly. The commission will be comprised of academic deans, teachers, principals, members of the business and industry communities, and a local school board member. Serving in an ex officio capacity will be the North Carolina Teacher of the Year, the North Carolina Principal of the Year, the North Carolina Superintendent of the Year, and the Chair of the SEAA and the Director of the Teaching Fellows Program. The Commission will determine both the student selection criteria and also select the award recipients. The commission will also set stringent criteria to choose the 5 most effective teacher preparation programs in the state of North Carolina to participate. Not only does this recognize our state's top teacher programs, it allows the teaching fellows recipients to enter their academic programs as a cohort. The UNC Board of Governors will appoint a director to the program who will be responsible for aggressive and strategic recruitment activities, including targeting regions of the state with the highest teacher attrition rates and recruitment challenges, actively engaging with educators, business leaders, and community leaders throughout North Carolina, and attracting candidates in STEM and special education to the program. The Superintendent of Public Instruction will also be responsible for identifying and providing to the commission those lists of STEM and special needs licensure areas that are in high demand, so that they always have up-to-date information on what they need to make the best decisions. The amount of the forgivable loan is up to $8,250. Any student with a high school, associate's, or bachelor's degree is eligible. That's right, I said bachelor's degree. Even students who wish to transfer or change their majors are eligible, and for different time periods. The loan forgiveness commitment is structured like this. Teachers have 10 years to repay the loan. If they choose to go into a low-performing school, they can pay the loan back on a year-to-year basis. For every year they use the loan, they get 1 year of loan forgiveness. If they do not choose to go into a low-performing school, then for every year they receive the loan, they will have to serve 2 years in the public schools. The State Education Assistance Authority will administer the loan portion of the program, and the amount that we are announcing today is proposed is $6 million, or about 160 teachers per year in groups of 30-person cohorts at the state's top 5 best programs in North Carolina. Now, I'm about to turn this over to my colleague, Representative Horn, but I also want to recognize, and I don't have enough time to do it, just the role that everyone behind us played in going through this process, specifically Dr. Maher from NC State University, Dr. Hank Weddington from Lenore Ryan College, or University, excuse me, in Hickory, and also President Spellings and Dr. Williams, and many others of their policy teams that work with us. But at this time, I'd like to turn it over to Representative Craig Horn.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Senator Barefoot. Before I begin, I want to thank some folks too. I want to thank some teachers across the state of North Carolina that came together, picked up the phone, called me, came to see me, and helped us develop this program. Coral Wiley, formerly of the North Carolina School of Science and Math, is now out at UC Berkeley. Donna Thomas from Hope County Public Schools, and Jennifer Stevens at UNC Greensboro. I couldn't start without thanking those people that were in the trenches facing the challenges and the frustrations. Now, North Carolina, like every other state in the union, continues to face a dramatic decline in teachers entering the profession. Our most immediate needs are for teachers in low-performing schools and in hard-to-fill subject matter such as science and math. Today, we ring the bell for the teachers. Come on, we need you. We want you, and we value you. We've been working for the last several years to raise teacher pay. That work will continue. The recession of 2007 to 2010 hurt this state a lot. Fact is, I think it hurt us more than most. We lost not just jobs, we lost virtually entire industries, and we lost teachers. North Carolina is among the fastest growing states in the nation. More people, more kids, fewer teachers. That didn't work. Today, I'm pleased to join with Senator Barefoot to announce the North Carolina Teaching Fellows Program, a program to attract new entries into the teaching profession in our state. We have many hard to staff positions in our schools, but particularly in STEM areas, both in rural counties and in our urban areas. We set the GO standards high. We expect a lot. We expect a lot from our kids, we expect a lot from our teachers. The North Carolina Teaching Fellow Program focuses on high standards and measurable results. We are involving the best of the best and overseeing the program that Senator Barefoot outlined. Real professionals from inside the teaching profession, people that have attained the highest levels of that profession and know what it takes to be successful. And we will continue to seek out and support those new teachers that fill our immediate needs and have demonstrated a commitment to serve in our most needed licensure areas. We greatly appreciate the support and cooperation of the University of North Carolina, our North Carolina Independent College Universities, our community colleges, our great elementary and secondary schools, public, private, charter, whatever works for the kid. We're in this together. I could not be happier to see North Carolina teaching fellows in North Carolina.
So before Representative Warren and I take some questions, we're going to call a few people in to make some comments. And first, I'd like to introduce to you Chancellor Woodson.
Good afternoon. Senator Barefoot, Representative Horn, and other members of the General Assembly, we're thrilled to have you here today. At NC State, we take our responsibility, our part of this mission, to educate teachers for science, math, engineering, and technology. And this building is a great example of that. So it's very appropriate that we would hold this press conference today in the Biotech Training and Education Center. Because for this building to be successful and to train the workforce for this growing industry in the state, we have to have young people graduating from our high schools that are prepared to enter this workforce. And this program today is really focused on that. So we're thrilled to have you here. We're thrilled to have been a part of this discussion to bring this program to North Carolina. And we're particularly proud at NC State to do our part. My real reason for being here is to introduce my boss. Which I love to do. And it's my pleasure today to introduce to all of you President Margaret Spellings of the University of North Carolina system. Before coming to the UNC system, President Spellings most recently served as the Chief Domestic Policy Advisor for President George W. Bush and as the U.S. Secretary of Education and then President of the George W. Bush Presidential Center, where she implemented programs focused on economic growth and education. President Spellings is one of those rare individuals that spent her life focused in education and educational reform, and we couldn't be more proud to have her in the great state of North Carolina now. Her reputation as an educational thought leader is one that we're very proud, as I said, to have here in our state. So please join me in welcoming President Margaret Spellings.
Senator Barefoot, Representative Horn, thank you very much for your leadership, your creativity, and most of all for involving all of us. We really greatly appreciate it. It's terrific to be on the NC State campus and in this beautiful facility where the magic happens. And thank you, Randy, for your hospitality. Preparing teachers to serve the state of North Carolina has always been a core part of the university's mission. Many of our public institutions began as teachers' colleges, focusing on educating our state's best and brightest to serve a rising generation of students. This bill keeps that tradition and builds on it, reflecting the value that our state places on teaching and the importance of keeping highly qualified professionals in every classroom and keeping this profession very attractive. We need talented, driven teachers in every single field. And I know that's going to be a focus for this legislature. Science, technology, math, and special education positions are particularly hard to fill because the market for those skills is so strong, as Senator Barefoot said. We see our strongest STEM graduates recruited before they've even graduated. Having a rich science and technology industry in North Carolina is an incredible boon to our state, but a challenge to our schools. This proposal will help strengthen our teaching core and demanding disciplines so that we can sustain these competitive fields for the long run and create jobs for the future. We're not just thinking about today's needs. We're looking to the state's long-range health, building an infrastructure of opportunity that will make a difference in North Carolina for generations to come. Thank you again to all of you, not just Senator Barefoot and Representative Horn, but all of you all who participated in this. We look forward to the enactment of the legislation and getting the bill signed.
Thank you, President Spillings. Next, I'd like to ask Dr. Hope Williams, President of the Independent Colleges and Universities, to come up.
Thank you, Senator and Representative Horn. Delighted to be here today. Like many of you, I was fortunate to have had an outstanding education in our North Carolina public schools with teachers who were great role models. And North Carolina has always had a significant commitment to excellence in education at all levels. In fact, just as President Spillings said about UNC institutions, many of our private nonprofit colleges and universities were established not only to expand higher education for North Carolina students, but also to educate more teachers for our public schools. That continued from the 1800s into the 1900s. Today, the preparation of teachers remains a major commitment of our independent colleges and universities. But recruiting students into teaching has become much more challenging. We need help from parents, from teachers, from the media, and certainly from the state in encouraging and allowing students to make the choice to become a teacher. The establishment of this Teaching Fellows program will show that North Carolina continues to be committed to helping schools of education recruit students into teaching in STEM and special education areas, that it is committed to helping our students be able to make the financial choice to become a teacher, and that it is committed to helping our local school districts be able to recruit and retain great teachers, especially for our low-performing schools. We have many teacher education programs in the former Teaching Fellows program. They thought very highly of it and know that it produced great teachers. We are excited about this, and I know that we're going to have many of our teacher education programs applying to be a part of the Teaching Fellows program. So I want to offer a special thanks to Senator Barefoot and Representative Horn for their support of this bill and the encouragement of this program.
Thank you, President Williams. And next, I'd like to introduce our new State Superintendent of Public Instruction, Mark Johnson.
Thank you. Education is the great equalizer of opportunity. A good education, whether vocational or college prep, is the best path for our students to reach their American dream. No matter where a student comes from, no matter their neighborhood, no matter their background, no matter their circumstances, they should be able to go to one of our schools in North Carolina, work hard, and be successful. And I thank Senator Barefoot and Representative Horn for their leadership. I thank everyone standing behind me for their effort in providing this program. This is the kind of innovation that will be the game changer for our schools. I recently had the privilege of visiting West Charlotte High School, where I was a teacher over 10 years ago. West Charlotte was a very difficult place to teach, an even more difficult place to be a student. But thanks to innovative strategies going on in West Charlotte to recruit some top talent teachers, West Charlotte's high school graduation rate has gone from 50% when I was there to almost 90% today. And they are monitoring diploma integrity. And programs like this will help get the top talent in the schools that need it most. The single most important resource for a student in school is the teacher. And I thank you so much for all the effort going on here and can't wait to support it as it goes forward. Thank you.
Thank you, Superintendent Johnson. And lastly, before we take questions, Dean Danowitz, Dean of the College of Education at NC State University.
Thank you very much, Senator Horn, Representative. This is a really important day for North Carolina. The announcement, I believe, shines a light on the pressing challenges facing our state. As has been said, and as we all know in this room, we have a growing teacher shortage and the need for more qualified teachers, especially in STEM fields and special education. I and my colleagues in the School of Education appreciate the commitment of our elected public officials and other government, nonprofit, business, and institutional leaders to support initiatives that prepare highly qualified educators for the state. I think that it's especially fitting that you've chosen to be at NC State, and we are honored by that. We in the College of Education have a straightforward commitment. We want all children, youth, and families to experience the promise of education. And we want all North Carolinians to be prepared for the workforce of today and tomorrow. To do that, we know we need great teachers. We already have many exceptional teachers working all across the state. NC State's College of Education alumni are teaching in nearly every county in North Carolina. We're the state's largest suppliers of STEM teachers. We are also home to one of the few elementary education preparation programs across the nation that has a STEM focus. Beyond excellent preparation in literacy and social studies, our students take significant amounts of mathematics and science courses, including courses in calculus, physics, engineering, and design for elementary teachers. Our graduates are committed to teaching quality mathematics and sciences to all elementary students and supporting the preparation of STEM education at the middle, high school, and then beyond as educated citizens. Today, we applaud the efforts of our elected public officials and others to address the challenges facing education, and particularly in regards to really shoring up the pipeline of qualified teachers in critical fields. I want to thank you for being here today and for our shared commitment that all of us have to increase access and affordability in order to prepare more excellent teachers to serve North Carolina and prepare responsible citizens and a workforce for the future. Thank you.
Thank you, Dean Danowitz. And when I got married 6 years ago, the lady who did our wedding said, don't lock your knees. So if any of you guys are feeling faint, I'll tell you what she told me, don't lock your knees. Okay, at this point, we would like to open it up for some questions for the media for a couple minutes, and then we will conclude our remarks. So are there any questions from the press or anybody?
This is Dewan from ABC 11. At what point did you recognize the need to create this fellowship program?
Well, as I pointed out, there is a report that is released every year that identifies hard-to-staff subject areas and also hard-to-staff geographic locations, and we've used that data to specifically inform our policy decision in this bill. Yes, ma'am. So there are a lot of innovative things that are going on in teacher preparation. NC State and Carolina just announced an online collaborative, a way to get to licensure very fast. So what we wanted to do is we wanted to say, hey, we want to take the best North Carolinians, and if they want to teach, no matter what stage they are at, they can come to this program and complete their education that way. I'll give you a great example. I don't know what kind of students are in there, but if you'll just look to your left, there are people doing serious work behind that glass. One of the ideas that we have, especially with this idea of you can change majors, let's say you're someone who comes to North Carolina State, you have very high hopes of becoming a doctor, you major in biology, you get to your junior year, you take that MCAT, and you realize you're talented, but that's not the path. What happens to you next? And so we want to incentivize the state to reach out to that person and say, have you thought about teaching? And if you've done well in your school, we can give you a scholarship.
I'd like to add to that just a little bit. We're all aware of the decline in teacher preparation enrollment. It's alleged to be in the 20% area here in North Carolina, much worse in many other states. Some of it's as 50 and 60% decline in enrollment. Where are we going to get more teachers? Because as I said earlier, we've got a growing population. That's more kids. we want to put not just warm bodies in front of them, we want to put highly qualified teachers in front of them. The source for a highly qualified teacher is not just the senior in high school entering college. That's a major source, but there are also other opportunities for us to attract and retain highly qualified teachers, get them into a teaching program. And that's what this version of Teaching Fellows does. It's a bit of a change and expansion so that we have, well, we're fishing in a bigger pond. There are a lot of people that start out to do lots of different things. One of my life experiences is that almost no one ends up doing what they started out to do. An awful lot of people get into other professions, but you know, I hear it all the time. I really like to teach. I really would. I can't afford it. But we're going to help with that. Teaching, you know, we all know you're not going to get rich as a teacher, putting it mildly. But we can help grease the wheels of progress, so to speak, and reinvigorate this pipeline, because we desperately need them. And this is an opportunity for us to do that.
So someone that has a bachelor's degree who decides to go to one of our fantastic Master of Teaching programs could be able to use the scholarship for that graduate school education and then enter the teaching workforce. I'll also tell you, from a financial perspective, it just makes sense. So instead of having all of your teaching fellows on a four-year forgivable loan track, you could have some that they're only getting 2 years of the loan or 1 year of the loan, so the money just goes farther, but it meets the students where they are at. Yes, ma'am.
Given that you're talking about students in STEM, do you think that the forgivable loan amount is enough to draw them into teaching? Higher salaries in the field?
So it's more than we've ever offered before. It's more than currently is available right now. And as I alluded, there are also going to be some bills rolling out that really try to wrap around this particular concentration. But I think it's a very competitive price point. Any other questions?
Just a follow-up to that. Will the participating teacher preparation programs be expected to either match or in any way contribute to the scholarship?
No, this is a up to $8,250 forgivable loan by the state of North Carolina. Okay. Well, thank you all for joining us today and being here. Thank you.